If you go into the ketosis, the stress metabolism that turns on this partial oxidation of fatty acids produces what they call the ketone bodies, but one of the ketone bodies is not a ketone, and it's the reduced state of this pairing of acetoacetate and beta-ketobutyrate, which is not a ketone. This is shifted so that it increases reductive imbalance. So it's almost as bad as lactate. So it's the stress that is creating this cycle of excess electron imbalance. And then that in turn activates things that can amplify, depending on the total situation, can amplify the stress reaction and the reductive excess of electrons. So that, for example, the formation of prostaglandins is turned on when there's a shift towards too many electrons, an imbalance in the direction of NADH rather than NAD, or of too much reduced sulfhydryl. People are talking, actually they're giving glutathione supplements to increase the electron abundance in the tissue, where the cancer cell already has an excess of electrons. It's a powerful antioxidant system that keeps the cancer cell alive, but in this defective state. And the same process that turns on prostaglandins, which create all kinds of inflammation and tendency to reproduce themselves without differentiating. It also turns on aromatase, which makes estrogen, which activates more of the tendency to produce excess electrons.